Good morning. We are finishing up our study on John 17. I'm not thinking that we're better than Martin Lloyd-Jones, who spent wrote four books on this passage. We've spent 5 days on it. We've just been water skiing over the top. And by the way, I want to remind you that next week there will not be video devotions. We're going to send out a devotion every morning, a written devotion every morning, but I'm not going to be recording devotions next week. We're trying to raise the production value of what we're doing, and we'll come out a week after that. But as I have noted, we are finishing up this high priestly prayer that's part of the Olivet Discourse. So yesterday, we saw the shift into away from the prayers for the 12, specifically into the prayers for all those who believe because of the work of the apostles. That's us. And we saw that then there was a primary prayer there that we would be one. We would be unified. That what unites us, Jesus Christ himself, who unites us and in whom we find our identity, so overwhelms us and overwhelms everything else that the divisions that we have or the disagreements that we have don't become divisions. And so I said, look, this is to be done in part because of verse 21, so that the world will notice. May they all be one as you, Father, are in me and I am in you. May they also be in us so that the world may believe you sent me. So there's a sense in which our unity is a testimony to the rest of the world. I then noted that we're not doing really well on this front and that this seems to be a particularly challenging time. To be clear, I'm not suggesting that we have to agree on everything, but I do think that we have to find ways to be agreeable with our brothers and sisters in Christ. So let me set 3 points in front of you here at the end of this study. Number one, do not compromise on the matters of the Apostles' Creed. There are things that we have to fight over. There are things that we have to take a stand over. There are things where we have to just say, look, this is not a negotiable. These are central to the claims of Jesus and the Christian faith, and I can't compromise on these things. To compromise on these things is to be outside of the Christian faith. That's the whole premise behind the Fence Post series. By the way, there's a whole bunch of secondary points that churches have not always agreed on. And so that is in sort of a concession to sin. That's where denominations came from. So you think we ought to have bishops and I think we ought to have elders. These are secondary points. I am only going to speak well of you. I am only going to say, yes, they are a Christ follower. Absolutely. But because we disagree on this, we either have to have bishops or have to have elder boards. We can't do both. We're going to have separate churches. Or you think we ought to meet on Saturday, I think we ought to meet on Sunday, right? These are secondary issues. And that's where the denominations came in. I'm only going to say good things about you. So the first thing is we can't compromise on the absolute essentials. We've got to find ways to hold tight to this central truth. But secondly, we've got to be very slow to contribute to any kind of division over matters that are not central to the faith. Let me say that again. We need to be very slow to contribute to any kind of division over matters that are not central to the faith. Doesn't mean that you can't have opinions and that your opinions are different from somebody else's opinions. Right? We can agree to disagree and do it in a loving, agreeable way. And do it with humility. You might be right. I might be wrong. I'm not gonna get ugly about this. I love the story told about Whitfield when somebody came up to him. So Whitfield and Wesley famously came down on different sides of the issue of God's sovereignty, human free will, that kind of thing. Somebody came up to Whitfield and said, "Hey, do you think Wesley is going to be in heaven?" George Whitfield said, "No, yes. Do you think we're going to see John Wesley in heaven?" And George Whitfield said, "No, I don't." And the guy said, "I knew it. I knew he wasn't even a Christian." And Whitfield said, "No, you've got me wrong. I actually think that John Wesley in heaven will be so close to Jesus, and I'll be so far away that I won't see him." That's the attitude that we've got to have, right? Look, if your theology is better than somebody else's. If you're more right, if you're closer to God and the truth on this, then your love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, gentleness, goodness, faithfulness, self-control, that'll be better. And if it's not, why in the world do you think you're right? So let's find ways to be kind and peaceable on these secondary issues. So third, I want to encourage you to pray to grow in wisdom and truth. I want to encourage you to pray for the protection of the church and the unity of the church. It is important to God. It is important to His witness. It is important to us. Have a good weekend.